Lucas Oil Drag Racing Series and you live anywhere else but Florida, that is why you come here to Auto Plus Raceway, home of the Amalie Motor Oil Gator Nationals. One of the historic, most prestigious races on the planet, and that's how you get crowds like this. They come down to enjoy the sun, they come out to enjoy the fun, and most of all, they come out to enjoy the racing. Alongside of the really tall guy, that's Alan Reinhart. I'm the short guy, Dave Reif. Our gal, Jamie Howell, will join us in just a minute. Did you bring some sunscreen for that, Al?
Yes, I did. As a matter of fact, I live in Arizona, so trust me when I tell you, I know all about sunscreen. But when you look at the weather, what's been happening in the country the last couple of months,
it's been brutal.
Yeah, that's why so many people come to Florida year after year. It's the spring break. It's the season opener on the East Coast, and folks flock here from everywhere, literally.
And they have had some Chamber of Commerce weather here this weekend. It was cool to start the weekend. It's been getting up near 80, and consequently, that's been giving us some great highlights. So what do you say we get right to it? Remember, the less talk, more action? Well, let's start it right now in Top Alcohol Dragster, where Dwayne Shields, the 2011 champ, struggled since then, but Dana Hopewell's back on the plan. That's Dan Page and Arthur Gallant's championship car, but that is Dwayne Shields walking away 536-1.
Dwayne qualified in the 520s in the number four spot. It definitely looks like the Peak team has found whatever the missing ingredient was. At least looks good this weekend.
Chris Demke's the Pomona winner. He's got a couple of Gator Nationals wins. Jared Dreher's going to keep him honest. Got almost 500 in the bank, but Demke got around him. More importantly,
that's the first time this weekend that Chris Demke didn't have to pedal the car. 528 steps up huge from qualifying, and he definitely needed it. 273 miles an hour, that's the margin at the stripe, but the car has been shaking so bad. Crew Chief Adam Rhodes has been fighting it. If Demke had to pedal again, he'd be pedaling his way back to California right now.
And do not adjust your sets. The Why Not Racing Top Alcohol Dragster is here. Jim Whiteley's not in the seat, though.
Mike Strasburg, who has worked with the Whiteleys basically since they started racing in alcohol, has never won a national event. Had a conversation with Jim. He said, hey, that's the car that won the last two championships. You'll fit in it. Climb in. Number two qualifier. Number one round win.
Car doesn't know the driver, but does move on to round number two. So it stacks up like this as Bill Reichert has moved into that second stanza and has lane choice against Robin Samsel. Dwayne Shield will pick his against Matthew Cummings. On the other side, Strasburg with that 528.8 actually gives up lane choice by 4,000 to Chris Demke.
Why not car in one lane, Chris Demke in the other lane? I believe we've seen that movie before.
But Mike Strasburg is in that championship winning car, and he's standing by right now with Jamie Howell.
Mike Strasburg has been to two national event finals, but as Jim Whiteley said, he's never won a Wally. So what kind of opportunity is this for you this weekend, Mike?
Well, it's incredible to have a car like this behind me and Jim and Annie Whiteley. Really great.
You've been with the Whiteley family for a while. We also see you race Nitro every once in a while. What kind of changes have you experienced here?
Well, it's a little hard to get used to a car like this where you have to bring it up to a lot higher RPM and you have to let the clutch out and you have to shift on time. Where the Nitro car, basically you leave from an idle. So it's a little different getting used to the difference.
Well, we already know you're going rounds today, so you're on the way to that Wally. Good luck.
Thank you.